So DRR stands for Disaster Risk Reduction. It includes activities that look at aware, prepare, and mitigate the risk of disaster within a community in a specific location that is prone to hazards. Being aware about the risk to be adequately prepared and avoid the disaster. Over the past 50 years, the number of hazards dramatically increased. Effect to global warming, climate change. As the hazards increased, the number of affected population increases. Now, particularly, Sudan is among one of the most vulnerable countries to climate change. Now, during 2020, floods in Sudan nearly affected 3 million people who lost their houses and properties, farmers that lost their crops, pastoralists that lost their livestock. In addition to floods, now the country is experiencing recurrent droughts, recurrent landslides, sandstorm, and lately the locust infestation. In a country in which economic situation is already fragile, people are left with not so many choices. Rural communities that might be impacted by those hazards without appropriate mitigation measures might be left with the feeling that move in another place and look for better option for their life can be the only solution. As mentioned, people hit by hazards without proper mitigation measure to possible disaster will see no way out. That is the reason why IOM is collaborating and supporting communities. The main objective of IOM Sudan in DRR is supporting communities to better understand and be prepared for hazards, supporting creating with them appropriate and sustainable mitigation measures, and therefore contribute to the community and individual resilience to those shocks. IOM has a strong partnership with the government of Sudan. We are able to operate and reach communities as the government understands the value of our work and support our action. Parallel to the work with the communities, we contribute to data gathering and evidence-based results to support the government of Sudan in moving forward the Sendai framework and contribute also to advocate about the importance of focusing in DRR activities. Now, ultimate scope is to work on humanitarian human mobility and contribute to policies at state and national level. We would like to remark about the importance of considering disaster risk reduction across all programming. Disaster risk reduction is everyone's business, enabling communities to better be aware and reduce their exposure to hazards will contribute to improve their resilience, which is a common goal for most humanitarian and development actors. Now, the more we talk about it, the more is shared and more people will understand the value of DRR.